Hey everyone, it's Ricky Molina from the Ricky Molina YouTube channel and RickyMolinaProductions.com. I just want to let you know about a recent experience I had uploading a music video onto YouTube. About a week and a half ago, I uploaded a video to YouTube in response to this recent lawsuit against Led Zeppelin and Warner Brothers regarding Stairway to Heaven, as filed by the estate of Randy California, also known as Randy Craig Wolf. And as you may have heard, the Randy Wolf estate is appealing the decision that was most recently ruled in favor of Led Zeppelin. But when I uploaded my original video with all these musical excerpts and comparisons of both Led Zeppelin and, you know, other artists as well, like Billy Joel, John Williams from Star Wars, Leonard Bernstein, Pearl Jam, Jem, and a host of others, soon after uploading my video onto YouTube, I noticed that there was a block, and it said something like, this video will not be playable in the United States as per copyright enforcement by WMG, which is like Warner Brothers Music Group, and they're the publishers of Led Zeppelin music, as well as a host of 65,000 other artists as well. So what I did was I edited out all the Led Zeppelin songs, and I thought that would probably do the trick. And I did a revision of the original video, and I uploaded that to YouTube, only to find that, once again, my video was blocked. So I think it has something to do with the court case that's going on. I'm not sure, but, you know, I tried my best to sort of clean up the video so that it abided by all the copyright laws and such. And I made the point that this is really for educational purposes only, and I'm only using excerpts from songs to show examples of how artists often copy ideas from previous artists and composers. And one of the things I discovered in doing this video was that, much to my surprise, is that this whole idea of plagiarizing or copying ideas from previous artists is really prevalent, especially in the early Led Zeppelin music and the early albums. Later on, not as much. So what I decided to do instead was to do an introductory video, as I'm doing right now on YouTube, and giving you an option to click on a link below this video to access a Vimeo upload that I made. And the video also appears on my website here, RickyMolinaProductions.com. And if you scroll down to my blog posts here, here's the latest blog post. And if you click on that, you'll see that there's a video player here embedded, and you can watch the entire video off of a Vimeo upload. And there's also a description of why I decided to do the video and a timeline of the songs. And interestingly, there's a spreadsheet that if you click on this link, it'll take you to a Google Sheets that you can download. And this is a spreadsheet with links to all the songs that I discuss in the video and the comparisons. The originals appear on the right-hand side, and the copies, if you will, the copycats are on the left-hand side. And I try to include links to YouTube videos where, you know, there are live performances, so it makes it that much more interesting. Okay, so you can access that spreadsheet and download it for free by clicking on this link. Now, I've also included links to all the songs that I cover in the video. And if you click on these links, you can actually purchase these songs and download them if you'd like. And at the very end, I include one of my own songs because, as I discuss in the video, I was inspired by Fleetwood Mac's Dreams to write a particular song that I wrote years ago called Denouement. And, you know, it's free on SoundCloud. Now, this particular recording that I made many, many moons ago before I knew, you know, half of what I know now about recording, so the recording quality is not that great. And I don't claim to be a great singer. I just wanted to show you sort of like the concept of how a groove from a particular song can influence a composer. Interestingly enough, as I mentioned in the video, you know, none of my friends, a lot of them are like musically inclined, could actually pinpoint the song that I copied in terms of the groove and such. They did not recognize any sort of original pop song, although I know for a fact that I actually was inspired by Dreams, in particular Stevie Nicks's Dreams, to write this particular song that I wrote many years ago. So I hope you enjoy this video. Remember that you can access it by clicking on the link just below in the description box. And I'd really like to know what you think about this whole subject of plagiarism in Led Zeppelin's music, as well as other music since Led Zeppelin. And if you'd like, you can leave a comment in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. It'll help me make more videos, more educational videos, product reviews, as well as uploading original compositions. This is Ricky Molina from RickyMolinaProductions.com and the Ricky Molina YouTube channel. I hope you enjoy the video. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day. Thank you.